right, all right.
What is up, everyone? I'm just getting settled in. I'm about to press play on my live stream. The live stream link, you know, I just realized I forgot to put it into my website. However, let me do that right now. My website's up and running with the stream. You're also live streaming on YouTube for the first time. First live stream there. Just testing out different things these last couple of weeks. So definitely take a peek at that. And So if you want to listen to what I'm listening to what I'm drawing to, that is the Dave Matthews Band live stream. You can find that on YouTube. Just go under Dave Matthews Band. And I do have a link under the YouTube description. So let's go take a peek at that. I'm about to start it at 18 minutes is the actual... 18 minutes and 2 seconds. I'm about to do that so that we can follow along and keep the music right. That is just a energy drink. Folks, let's do this. Let me just make sure everything's running good. Excellent hat there. Good there. Perfect. All right. Everything's good. Awesome. Yay. Let's do this. So, created this last night off of the live stream, and I lost my focus. It's like no matter what I do. Sorry, folks, I have this manual focus on this webcam. Hopefully by the holidays I'll be able to get a new webcam and have some autofocus on that. So, made this yesterday, did a little sketch, did it with my pastel pencils, and started out with the pastel pencils, and I was just sitting down, wasn't really planning on doing anything, so I just grabbed this Canson Metant artboard, and, well, just came up with it, and then eventually after about 30 minutes, I introduced some soft pastels and some hard pastels as well, and I have this, and so this morning I'm like, might as well just keep going with it, and it was fun. This is, again, Dave Matthews Band. This is from a 2008 live stream that they did, featuring LeRoi Moore. This was his last show. His last live show, unfortunately, shortly after that is when he passed away. Due to complications from an ATV accident, but also has a let's see, Dave here. Sorry, I was because yesterday I almost had Dave over here, and then I had the start over here. Dave here, Tim Reynolds, Rashawn, Boyd, Carter, and then Stefan, and then the little couple here is the it's from my piece "I Fall So Hard." You can actually see that on the YouTube channel. I have a little time lapse of it. It's one of the early ones, the first or second one. This came about, this little couple, when I was just listening to the song. The song is actually called Idea of You, but the title of my artwork was called I Fall So Hard, because the song is I Fall So Hard Inside inside the Idea of You. So really, really good song. This image kind of came to me, and I just kept working with it, eventually made that painting that's in it. And so every time you see this image in one of my Dave Matthews pieces, that means that they were playing the song during that. So that's about it. Little background there. Again, 16 by 20 Canson Metant artboard. This is actually what I usually take with me to live concerts. It works perfect right in the hand, right in the arm. And you kind of just hold it and just rock out and jam and do that. So let's just get on to it. Again, there's no photo reference. I'm just going off the live stream. If you've seen a lot of my live stream artworks, it's really just kind of going off of there, them jamming out and piecing stuff together. So, if you do not want to be bored, jump on the, whatever music you like to listen to, unless you like my voice, and let me know if I need to go a little louder. Dave Matthews Band, YouTube. It's the first one that they should have from the Bristow Show 2008, and start it at 18 minutes. I'm gonna start that off right now. Let's do it. Let's have some fun. So. Since everything's here, I of course now want to start from the back forward and bringing everything up. I apologize if I keep bumping into this here. This is a slightly different setup for me. But, alright. So it's going to jam out. Put whatever Dave Matthews Band music you want on right now. Their fundraiser for this was is No Kid Hungry. So they should have a link on there as well, too, if you're watching their show. Or you can just go to the No Kid Hungry website and make a donation. Alright. So let's just kind of... That's where I kind of want it there. Alright. So what I'm doing is actually I have it playing in... The headphones is on my old phone, repurposing it. And then... But on my TV is where I actually have my photo, my reference, my video reference. So I'm kind of looking over here. So when I'm looking at you, I'm actually looking at the TV. So it's much more personal now. And this should all be here. Hopefully my audio's in sync. Let me know. Again, this whole month of August is to at least get started with live streams, but also make improvements and learn. So your comments are always appreciated. I don't really take offense to anything, so... Well, that's, maybe I do, actually. Maybe I haven't found it yet. Okay. So that's the first song of theirs is kicking off. So what I want to do eventually is have LeRoi popped out a little bit more from that background. So I want to soften this just a little bit. And so what I'm using is a little soft pastel. These are Rembrandts. And the blending, though, on Canson Mitant, you don't have as many layers as you would, say, on the UART paper that I also work on. So you just got to be a little more thoughtful of how you're going to place things down. There's still some pastels, certain colors that still apply on it very easily, but compared to, say, the sanded paper, like, again, UART, those are the only two papers I've used. So that's why I only mentioned those two. So I got to be careful. And then mixing soft pastels and hard pastels back and forth doesn't really vibe. So you got to be careful with that too. You got limited combinations with those, as I have found. Alright. So I'm just going to soften that background. And it does look pretty much, yeah, it's all fuzzy. That's how everything looks right now. Nothing's in focus because that's how the gestures look right now. So if you're probably thinking, Alex, your camera's off, it is not right now. Of course, as soon as I do put some brighter, sharper areas and get a main good area of focus, which will probably be Lassard, that'll make things a little bit better. Folks, I also have a little tip bucket there. You'll see in the link in my description. So if you like what I'm doing, take a peek at my website. If you're just watching this on YouTube, take a peek at my website, ajccreative.com. See all the other stuff I've done and subscribe to my channel. Help me grow. It'd be fun to look back on these in, say, a year or two and see what has changed. But yeah, if you like my artwork on there and enjoy what I'm doing, want to support the cause, leave a tip there, and then you'll actually see the little tip bucket right above me. A little coin will drop in there and that little fun stuff. And that tip donation is all ran through my Streamlabs account, which is also hooked up to my PayPal account. And yeah, that's about it. I know some people just like to know if things are secure or not. Folks, I hope you are listening to music right now. All right, so it's kind of soft now. And Let's put some more of this shadow green in. And see what else here. Let's get going. Now, I don't think I'll bring this to a conclusion at the end of this live stream. The stream will probably be about an hour to maybe an hour and a half. Sometimes I do go 2 hours when I really get jamming. So we'll see. So, as you know, I don't really want to lose some of the stuff I've already have, a lot of that energy, kind of the whiskiness back and forth, that motion. But I need to bring that background into place a little more. There we go. Honestly, I don't really know what I want to do with this just yet. There's a shadow that was getting cast from up there. There we go. Eventually we'll get LeRoi popping a little more. Actually, I'm not sure how much I want him to pop. Leave some comments. Let me know what favorite bands you like. You know, some live streams happening. Maybe I can catch those. So what colors do I want to bring into that background more? Because right now it's just kind of like that gray, green, well, warm gray, I should say. Let's bring in some brown. Don't want too much color because I want it to. Yeah, I just don't want it to be all black back there. However, it could be dark. A lot of shadows. Maybe that kind of brings in that kind of blends in a little bit with the background. A little bit of shoulder. There we go. Alright. And then these little thin ones. These are Prismacolor new pastels. And these are hard pastels. compared to those are soft pastels. And they run in the same family of pastels, but you also have oil pastels, which are a different type, a little more waxier. Those tend not to fall in the same category when it comes to, say, pastel competitions, things like that, or soft pastel only competitions. I'm not too familiar with soft pastels. I'm barely getting to those pretty much this last year and a half. It's always been the new pastels, mainly because that's what was given to me back in high school, and I learned from there. And yeah, that's about it. Excellent story, Alex. Subtle. That's enough. So with live streams, talking to those who haven't seen these yet, I can always just take a photo and just look at it and draw it. And that's how I started a lot, pretty much, with artwork. But live music art was trying to draw them at concerts while they're performing and just trying to capture that in the dark, and a lot of gestures, stuff like that. But eventually you try to capture the shape of their head, you know, certain things that make them, without having to worry about like the details of like the eyes, you know, per se. And so when it comes to LeRoi, he had his sunglasses, so that helped. At least he had them early on when I put them on, and then later on he took them off, and I was like, oh well, good thing I put them on earlier. Because things like that, you know, hats, long hair, short hair, certain things, well, short hair could be tough if the individuals are kind of built the same. You have to find other things. But that's kind of, you know, you look at those certain little parts, those shapes, and you kind of mark them down really quick. And as you're seeing, you know, that's kind of what I'm doing here. And sometimes you get lucky. That's really it. You rely a lot on, you know, fundamentals. As if, like, you know, if you've ever taken drawing classes and you have a live model and you're just doing basic sketches, skeleton sketches, things like that. Where you're not focused on, say, the bone or the skin and everything, and the full body, you're mainly just, you know, focused on, you know, the arm, you know, kind of going up here, this way, type of thing, stuff like that. And so that's how like a lot of this kind of built up and got going. One second, let me. Okay. So, back at it. So things are kind of fuzzy, but right after we get some of these foundation layers in and established, then we can start making some more sharp edges, and then we can get some focus in it. And let me have like one finger left that doesn't have any pastel. All right. I think we're about to start the third song. Yeah, Old Dirt Hill just ended. I wish I could play the music. I would love to, but you know, we don't have copyrights, and definitely want to always respect that. I'm hoping it's okay that I actually have them in my headphones as I'm jamming, because it's actually how I, you know, I'm creating to the concert. It's not just playing random playlists, things like that. So in a way, this is, the artwork ends up kind of being like my cover of the concert. And if that makes any sense. It doesn't to me, so don't worry. Alright. So, let's start bringing this up just a little bit now. Now that background's in place. Actually, let's... I hope if by watching this you just get encouraged to turn on your favorite music and draw to them, and not just as its background music, but just let yourself get into the music, like really, really do, kind of like, you know, when you're by yourself and you're dancing and singing along type of thing, or when you're in your car with the windows rolled up and no one can hear you, all that fun stuff. Do it. Make sure there's a pencil, a pen, a pastel in my case, handy, and dance with the canvas. It's just a lot of scribbles. Eventually you start making people's shapes, and then you start kind of learning to shape them a little bit more and a little bit more. And after quite a few times, you're like, hey, it kind of looks like Dave Matthews, or it kind of looks like such and such. For all the bands I've drawn, like, multiple times, they never really all look the same, and that's okay. They still resemble them somewhat, some more than others. But it's just important to try. It's just fun. It's freeing for me, and I just think people enjoy it. Don't force it. Just let it come to you. The one difference between doing this at home and then the live stream concerts compared to a live music concert, when I'm actually there, I'm holding this in my hand, as I mentioned earlier, or I'm holding it in my arm, but I'm dancing with it. So when, you know, live music, you know, they're there jamming and just it's just doing their thing. You're in that zone. You're in that moment. I find that's what I'm missing right now. And so I guess I could pick it up right now, but then I don't have a camera to follow that type of motion where I'm just dancing around here in my living room. And start bringing that shoulder out a little bit more. Just a little bit. I'm still not sure where I want it to go, roughly. We still got Carter Beaufort here on the drums. Make sure I stay on the
the chat. Last time I didn't, one of the first times I did, and my friend just like blew it up with like all kinds of individual ones. It was a good conversation.
Alright.
So here is a saxophone, but it's going from this motion to this motion and then this motion. So we want to keep that. But to bring it forward, we're going to apply more pressure with the pastel as we dance with it, with the beat. And I know it doesn't make sense, but it kind of does. But
okay,
so see how it's a little bit more vibrant now, it's kind of popped out a little bit more. And what we'll do is we'll put a more of a shadow color behind it, not as much, just a couple little streaks, just to give the eye something to kind of follow back there. Like after it'll first see this first layer, that bright yellow, then it'll see that little olive green, then it goes to the shadow black. There we go. And then eventually we'll put some highlights where it'll be nice and bright, certain shines. And yeah. All right.
Actually, we can probably refocus that on that part now. There we go.
All right.
Cool.
You know, I'm going to, before I jump over, I'm going to take this pink and going to get some small highlights just right on top. So this is kind of the top of the forehead, right about here-ish, because he's kind of looking down. So he's like right there. If you look at me, that's kind of like his, not all the way down, just... So I got that. Just a little bit. It's only going to be up there. Okay. And we're also going to put it... Relax, because we don't want to jump into the full shape of him just yet. We're going to let it piece together a little bit more. We'll wait for some more jamming moments when he's really going, doing his thing. So for now, let's just keep working with this background just a little bit more. And all I'm doing is just taking a black pastel and just adding some. It's almost like they're curtains in a way back there. But I'm my pressure on it is barely touching. It's not like a strong. Kind of go with this one here. There are a lot of shadow ones that look roughly the same. Slight hint, as you can tell. A little more green, a little more on the olive side, and then more of just the charcoal. So I'm going to go with more of the green, or excuse me, the olive. And just back here, we're going to kind of pretend, we're going to ignore all this front stuff, and we're going to pretend that we see the this part of the saxophone just a little bit. As I get this really right there. Again, so this way when the eye's coming back and forth, you'll see this. I'll have some dark shadows right up here eventually when I get those added in. Same down here. And we go from that dark blue, dark dark brown, the black shadows, or what's like the deepest area of the blacks, or for the shadow area right about here. And then the saxophone part comes up right here with that dark, dark green shadow. More of a shadow, I should say green. Wish I knew the color, or the names of the colors. I don't. Alright. So it's just kind of roughly right here, as you can see. Alright. Let's get a little closer now. Just because we're not going to be working on that background for a bit. There we go. Give him some more here on Boyd here. You know, I think I just messed up my white balance, unfortunately. I'm using my phone for my other camera back here, which is the ESOL camera. Doing here, I'm just warming him up with using the purple, the dark purple that's already back there, that shadow, and then bringing up the next step with this violet. And this right, because this color, this, you're not seeing this purples right. Should be a little bit better for us. Cool. It was a subtle difference, but it made a difference. Alright. So let's continue with Boyd here. We're just going to add a little bit of... We're kind of just going to repeat this dark blue right here. The amount of pressure just to kind of brighten it up a little bit more. More intense, and it's really it. Just kind of bring him up a little bit forward. And then we're going to take the blue and do the same thing. Bring those areas up. We're going to leave this leg back here a little bit more just to kind of show that leg's coming up a little further. Nice and simple, nice and easy. It's just too hot. I don't have AC, and I shouldn't have shut that window. All right. Folks, maybe one of these days I'll have one of those really cool, you know, sweet streams, you know, that everyone has right now, and perfectly edited, but I don't. I'll get there, though. And, all right. So, we have him here, and he still looks a little fuzzy, so as soon as we put his glasses, let's just put his glasses in now. We're going to take this same blue again, and all we're going to do is just fill in. The shape I already made. There. And then we're going to take this blue also. We're going to add some shadow back here underneath that hair because it kind of comes around. This hair kind of just goes all over. Perfect. And then we're going to take like a. Let's see. I'm going to have to reach over to my other pastels. That for his to warm up those arms. Right here. I'm not going to worry about the shoulder or that back area, but just to really help separate the front arm or the forearm, the front arm. I guess it is in the front, but the forearm to the bicep and the shoulder. That's by putting that line right there. And then let's see, he had his violin here. Nope. Violin, what else is. If I mistake, the violin was there, which brings his hands on this side here. There we go. And let's put a little highlight on the head. Up on top. There we go. Nice and simple. Nice and simple. Folks, it's live. I can't do any editing, so if a big burp happens to come out, I apologize for that. As soon as I just finished that energy drink, I'm like, oh, uh-oh. All right. Cool. So now, let's bring in Dave a little bit more. We're going to have him pop out a little bit more. And we'll do this with all of them until we find a little balance. And then I'll just keep repeating what I need to. We'll add the music. The music part's fun because it's really when, you know, they're really jamming out. And you kind of just... And that's how I do it. And it's fun to me. Nice. If I had something popping up, since I had that there, let's do this here. Just kind of floating there. It's like, what the heck? It's just a different. It's not part of that. It's just more up here, and that'll attach to some other layers up here eventually. It'll probably has a little flow here, so maybe here. Here. And then, ooh, there he goes. right there, and it's going to connect right there. Boom. And we'll do more with that in a bit. We just want to make sure we're following the... There we go. I haven't even looked at the screen in a while. The camera, but to actually like use any resemblance, I'm having fun just with what I have and just going with it. And again, if I wanted to like really have it be them exactly, I would just get a photo and do it, but this is more fun and challenging too, because I still want to kind of resemble them. And okay, let's just kind of adjust a little bit there, and let's go a little bit brighter, maybe not that one just yet, but this one. And wait, did they already play a... They're about to play I Fall So Hard, or Idea of You. And, so while they do that, let's jam out on this little guy here. Not much to do. So they're here, and the couple's here, and they're pretty much about to kiss. You know, she's here holding her hand up on his head. He's here wrapped around, type of thing. And then you just have fun with the song and just, you know, be cool with it. I'll stay here, but I... Let's turn my like this. There we go. Goes. So all I'm doing is just adding some stuff right here. You and all your free friends, you pick me up, you brush me off like rain. When you fall from me, you're holding big in the car. Brush you off, I'm gonna be in my shit, boom, boom, boom. And to make the hand stand out from the arm and everything, I'm just gonna use that bright color again, but I'm only gonna put it on the hand area. With you, I can't say what I mean. I wanna stay. We'll bring this highlight to bring his shoulder, have that separate. Idea of you. Yeah, look at them. They're just in love. They're in love. Yeah, but let's shape that up just a little bit. Wake up and you're gone, you're gone. And the way it works when I was making the picture, I Fall So Hard, they came about from the flowers and everything, and they were kind of... I know, it's... I got some cheesy stuff, man, but... When it comes to drawing and music and putting it together, I don't even care about it. I don't even care how cheesy...
Side the idea of you... That's why with you, I can't say what I mean. I wanna stay, but I think I'm getting out of here. I fall so hard.
Let's combine some of his blue up there. That's a good combination right there. Summer falling, for you and all your cool friends. You pick me up, you brush me off, arguing. See, now the music's starting to slowly come out. These dots here are music. I know you can't see that because I'm not really adding anything up here, so you don't have to worry. It's just kind of going here, and then I go off the grid and come back around. Let's bright this up. Oh. What I love about this stream as well, too, is that so after this song that they play, which I really, really like, and especially like Drawing 2, they played a version of Cornbread, which is one of my favorite versions. It's on a playlist of mine that I'm always jamming to. And Tim Reynolds just goes off on this riff, and he's just going, the whole, it's just awesome. And from the beginning, when you gotta do what you gotta do. And I sound really ridiculous right now, but if you listen to the song, it's awesome. It's about 59 minutes into the stream. People who like Dave Matthews Band know what I'm talking about. It's like I keep forgetting you can't hear the song, and it's like everything I'm jamming to, but you're not getting that emotion that I'm getting right now. Bum, 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 bum. Ooh, that's actually a little too dark or too bright. This must just fade away. There we go. Let's make sure he stays up front of that. So let's just bring, there we go. Excuse me. All right, so he's in. Let's get Carter Beaufort in since he's, we're working right with up here. He has so much stuff in his setup as a drummer is crazy. So I'm just having fun just putting certain marks here and there and as shadows, and then we'll pick and choose which ones we want to bring forward. So since he's tan already, we can't use that color for... And my color's never really... mash, you know, I just use colors for whatever. But he's a highlight this time, and he's gonna be a green. That's his main color. More of that shadow green. So we can't use the bright yellow for the color of the of certain areas of the drum setup. But we'll bring some orange in. Of this innocent that you inspire, you know you are. Open up your lovely flower. All right. So it's starting to come together. Let's this is going to kind of be in front of that. But before we put all those in, let's capture his arm just because I was looking at it right there.
And reach around him.
Top part of his leg, his thigh. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. And then this will follow here. They go off on their separate ways. Because they don't find each other until they're here, until they meet up. It's like they have to get to go through a little journey to find each other. Let me check on the stream. Oh gosh, I forgot. Hopefully no one's or I would like if you guys chatted. But okay. We're good, everything's still running happy, awesome, cool. That's about it. So see how it's starting to crisp up just a little bit now that we're starting to bring some of those highlights? Or midtones, I should say. Those are not even the highlights. We're barely like in the midtone area.
You know you are gonna have one until you...
So it's gonna go, this is going into the distance right here. This is going away.
The side of your head is on the other side. To make it happen, you know. Inside your head, all that we need to make it.
And these shadows here could be the probably the most intense. This, I thought it was going to be down here, but this would be the furthest away. Still enough, not as much more, because for Sean Ross is helping us with that whole direction of things here. So let's blend this. All right. All right. Slowly but surely. I said I was going to work on Dave, and I didn't even bring him up. Well, it's because that song came on, that's right.
First up is hardest of all.
Let's calm that down just a little bit real quick.
I'm walking in tall. Said you never did. Oh.
You know, help. Let's do some small lines there. Get that distance back there. His leg can now actually come with that. Alright, let's get him in here.
To the fire.
You know what? That's not a good angle for you. My hand's going to block it. Since I'm on this side for a bit. Since I know I'm going to be on this side for a bit, let's adjust that. There we go.
No problem, right? Quick fix. There we go.
Ooh, actually, you know what? Since he's jamming right now.
Get it. If you get it. If you get it. You begin to live. Begin.
So folks, I'm barely whispering, so you're not going to hear my voice right now. Sorry. You know what we need? We need a, not yet. We're gonna hold just a little bit. Okay. Get it, Rashawn. And some of this, you know, I don't want it to cross like that. It's also important to keep certain energy lines, and what I mean by that is, like, you know, the certain motion. Consistent with whatever it is you're doing. They don't all have to match each other, but, and the purpose of that is just, I like to be able to sit back on the couch, put it at a distance, and then follow, you know, this one here, and then next thing you know, I'll follow this pattern here on its own, and then I'll follow this other one, and it's, they're all their own different ones, and they're kind of at their own different depth. You know, we'll have some that are closer here, then further back, which you can't tell right now, but once I add some different highlights, things like that, they'll start doing that, and they'll go from up close, and they'll, you know, curve around kind of like a ribbon, you know, the flow around that way, and do that whole stuff. It just takes a while to bring it together. And then this is actually gonna, it's gonna like swirl down just enough, you know, not even there. We're gonna get rid of that a little bit. And we're going to follow this motion here with some good crisp shadow lines. That's all. It's almost like it went shoo, and then it's kinda. And then to add to that and to get that motion more, we'll bring the same color that's here. And we'll add a couple little flows, little flow lines. There we go. Let's connect a little bit more like that. And come back in. So we're kind of taking what was already naturally put down in the very beginning, and then we're just adapting to it. I like doing that because it's kind of like trying to capture it live, like the first throwdown during the live show, or the first time seeing the stream type of thing. Just like I do at concerts. Right with the concert's done, I take it home, I see what I have, and then I start working it, just like how I do here, bringing out certain things and making sure I stick with certain patterns. To kind of just keep, I don't know, seems like I just kind of keep true to it and everything. So it's, so it's not about coming back and like, oh, well, I got to make him look like this. Like, I mean, if there was no hint of LeRoi Moore right here at all, I'd be changing some stuff up. There's barely a hint of Dave just because I've drawn him so many times this way. Or not this way, but just with a certain arm area to where I know what it's going to come about. But it doesn't really look like him at all. Same with Tim Reynolds. And or probably even Rashawn. Unless you know the band members. Probably it's just LeRoi and Boyd right now. And that's cool because I've only been drawing this band live since like 2018, and at least pastel wise, and unfortunately they weren't part of the band anymore. Alright, let's come back to this again. We'll revisit it. Remember, there's no rush. We're not I'm not trying to get this done under a certain amount of time, just letting it come to me and just build and build, and then after a while I'll look at it and be like, you know, there's nothing else to do, and that's when it's done.
Check my computer. Man, my computer's running like a champ right now. This is awesome. I bet that was such a good deal, too.
Let's get a little bit more. Let's keep working on this bottom area. We're gonna focus on. Actually, he's a little bit better crisp right now. Cool. So, see how it's patching together slowly but surely? Let's add. Like a rust copper color here for. Actually. No, not even that color. Let's just go dark brown. Or some shadow. That'll be his neck. Here. And then. Bada ba bum bum, bada ba bum bum. Now you can't really see this right now, but it's like it's really. I'm just trying to carve out
and we're gonna have to bring in a soft pastel instead.
You for me. We're running out of layer there, and I gotta get that shaped out. Time for you, love.
Alright.
Space between. This area is done. I did a bad combo of soft and hard pastels to where I ran out of layer on it now. But that's okay. I have the hair I can add still that goes right over it still. Talking. And the stranger lies. There you go. Now he's starting up here.
The wild wild space between.
Hello there, Timmy.
Safe from the pain. Will I hold you again?
Let's have him pop out here a little more with. Let's get the right edge. There we go. I'm good to go.
Space between. And now fireflies. I'll be having waiting for you. The rain will fall.
And then his arm's jamming out, so let's not make it solid. Let's just kind of get the motion there.
Take my hand, cause we're walking out. Right out of here.
get his shoulder strap right there. And then when you hide every time for you. Folks, I do apologize for my terrible singing, my half words and stuff like that. And if I wasn't drawing, I probably wouldn't be singing to all of you. So please bear with me. And feel free to mute it. Alright, let's get a little bit of a shape right here. We'll shape it up just by putting the... Actually... Smells like rain. Ah, such a good smell. Alright, what color should we make the guitar? Timmy's is already repping the red and white guitar. Let's see, Dave. Matthews will be... If he's green as well, he's almost the same green as Carter Green and Rashawn Green. Let's see. I think we'll just go with. Let's need a little separation right there. And I just mean by that by separating his music energy from the background here. And we'll just do that by adding a couple more there. Let's keep this blue theme here. You know, let's make his hair a little cream color. And we'll do that. I only have this little bit left, though. The fruit and the highlight will come from this side, so not on this here. What's up, Mason? He will get. Ooh, should I do white? No, let's stick with. Let's go with this very. Clean it off. This one has a nice sharp edge already cut to it. And I think it'll work. We're gonna use this like sky blue. Not sky blue, well, there's a little bit of green in here. We're going to use that as a highlight for the... We're just following the lines that are already there. And then there's going to be some right here. You don't have to follow all of it. The motion will kind of help the viewer's eye. So here, boom, boom. A couple of random ones. There we go. I really want to put one there, but actually, yeah. Let's brighten that one up. This is the new stuff. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm. Not too much. We don't want this as bright as that, because then it just, this defeats the whole purpose. It won't be up front. It won't be in front of it. It's going to go behind it. So we'll actually probably come back and soften it just a little bit more. Let's do that. Kick the habit. All right. Cool. Now again, folks, not all my streams are like this. You know, last one was using a photo reference on the sky, which we'll definitely do again on Monday. This Saturday, I'm trying to figure out what I should do. I want to do something a little different. I'm going to see if any friends are available, either to do like a virtual pastel portrait where they're just there hanging out, and we'll probably just be talking random, you know, talk, but maybe they're there, and I'll just try to draw them, you know, as a reference, as they're sitting in. I can easily just have a picture of them there, but I think it'd just be more fun for them to actually be there and sit in while I do it, and maybe that'll be fun. So I'm gonna see what I can arrange there. If not, I'll be drawing something, or I'll continue on another piece of artwork, or I'll just make something up. Let me know what you'd like to see in the comments. If it doesn't hit this episode, next episode, maybe a future one, a not so distant future one. All right, you know, we don't really have to worry about his legs too much. But we're going to do this green shadow back there just to kind of get something. And then, there we go. Just a little bit. All right. Cool. Oh, Timmy, I want a little bit more color. And I have no way of getting it on there. Bummer. I think there's a chance. Yes, there is. I almost forgot I had this one. Sendlier, I believe I pronounced it right. I hope I did. I have a couple of these. This soft pastel should softly go right over. Yep, that's exactly what I need. See how it's just kind of laying right on top of it? You could barely see it, but before with the other pastels, I ran out of layers. Sometimes if you have a soft enough pastel, you can go back in there. Cool. And now he looks like he's all choppy. Or chunky, I should say. Blotchy. Blotchy is more of a... There we go. But the devil have any more. And the Lord that I might have gave me. The devil to the floor. There we go. Alright, cool. Back to Dave. Matthews. Dave Matthews is gonna go. We're gonna have him yelling out this way. Excuse me, singing, yelling. Well, scream yelling, you know, singing. Because he's like, ah! And then that energy just goes here. It is. Yeah, I'm on now. Yeah, hey, hey. All right, so we're just going to get a basic shape. All in the states of confusion. Yeah, I'm on a yay. All right, so we're just going to. We're gonna blotch him in. Whoa. That one got carried away there, and that's all right. Maybe, actually. The one that my mother gave me. To the floor. And there's a shadow right here of this going down. The guitar right there. Knees. I'm gonna drop the devil to his knees. Alright. Yeah, this is just more just a an open project for me. Like I said, it came about yesterday. Now I'm just going to see it through to the finish. And once I'm finished, I will have figured out if I'll even put this up for sale or just keep it for myself. I don't know. Some I usually know right then and there what I'm going to do with them. Whether they'll sell or not, it's just during it, it's like, you know what, we're going to put this one up for sale. And others, it's like, you know what, I don't want anyone to have this but me. To the knees, I'm going to drop the... So, we don't want that there, so I'm going to leave a little bit of black just down here. There we go.
Alright,
so we got that. Let's do some... Get some violet right here for the strings, or more for the bar. Praise God. Da, 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 da. So we've got them here. Let's get a different blue. I like that one. We use this for his hairline, which is very, very subtle, but it'll help us just right there. Oop, and then a tiny bit there. And then we'll come back and put some shadows on that. It's not going to stay that bright blue.
Starting to, things are starting to come to focus. It looks a little bit crisper now. And
like a part of me wants to fill that part in, but that's really going well with the whole shadow area. So let's just use a charcoal, keep that background canvas color in a way, and just kind of, and we'll figure it out. There we go. Story told down by the bayou. And we'll get some ears. See, that's kind of tilted this way, so it's going to go a little more almost horizontal. There. Nope. I said horizontal hand. There we go. Now, there's other easy ways, I shouldn't say easier, but just maybe quicker ways. I can go about this with a pastel pencil, get a nice, really thin line. But I don't know, I found like over time that even though I started this with a pastel pencil, I like working from, you know, it's all blotchy, you know, big sections to smaller. And then to where when I do need to break, to get a sharper edge on the pastel itself, I'll just break it, use a nice sharp edge, and do that for the sharper edges. And those lines can sometimes get as thin as, you know, down here as they were earlier. But then when, if I want to get even thinner, I bust out a pastel pencil like this, which you won't be able to see that color, but then I'll have even a thinner line here, which helps for when you're going to the distance. I wasn't planning on doing that. I was more brought it out just to demonstrate how thin it was, but that's working for down there. And the only reason I work that way, you know, from bigger to little, is just to go, it's just to help me just work on my technique a little bit more, to develop that type of process. Seeing the shapes first, the larger shapes, and then breaking it down more and more. Yeah. And so, it's whatever works for you. Alright, so he's there. Let's get a little more... What color do I want? A green. A nice, good... Not that green. Maybe this... No way. Oh, yeah. Maybe up here. Ooh, here we go.
Let's stick with this one. We're just gonna get a nice shadow right here.
And we're gonna continue that shadow from here, right up over here, and just put a little bit behind it. So then it kind of gives the effect like the face is kind of ch-ch. And by ch-ch, it means like pieces are going from here to here. And then eventually we'll get a darker area right up in here to show that it's like a mouth opening up. And he's like, ah, yeah, 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 yeah. There we go. And then we'll go a little bit darker. Just on the left side of that green shape.
There we go. Then we will take a pastel pencil, preferably a blue
streak, just to keep that dark color here. We're gonna follow these lines here. This is something you kind of really can't see unless like you're literally in front of it.
All right, this works. All right, cool. It looks, let's focus on him.
Yeah. So now to figure this little area, and all we gotta do spend a little bit extra time right in this section here, dividing that up. Softly just adding some values here and there
to thin it up.
Separate that background. You can always come back to the face again and fix our shapes if needed. Yeah, let's come back and go over those lines again. It was just, it seemed like it was just on the same, that background was on the same plane as the head there. Alright, I think that's a little bit better. Alright, and what we can do to help out that, him, is give him a bright highlight, like a nice good green, like a lime green. More on the yellow side. Just a highlight up top. Alright, just keeping that shape nice and simple. It's like I kind of over did it there that I wanted to. That's okay. See, it's using my background colors to shape the head, and then using the shape to in the body up here to kind of shape whatever else I need out of the background, if that made any sense whatsoever. You know what? Let's get this right there. We need that nose. We need that hint of that nose right there.
Go. He be jamming. He is jamming.
Shadow.
Right. Cool.
So he's pieced in. Let's separate that background right there off of that chin. Then you got the chin, background.
Perfect, but it's perfect for that. Let's get a,
you'll find that I tend to use this blue a lot in my pictures. I just really like it. And
all right, let's
Let's go move over here to Lassard. And so we're gonna work on our buddy here. Sorry, I also have pastels over here on this side, and let's see what else matches. Wow, it's already almost 10. Wow, it's already an hour and a half. We've been definitely got into it. Already hit my mark, but we're just gonna keep going forward, at least to the 2 hour mark, and we'll stop there. I'm gonna go out, grab a glass of water. I think that might be good for me to take like a quick 15-20 second break. That's just 15-20 seconds. I'll be right back.
Oh, and stretch. Oh my god. Sometimes I just forget how long I've been sitting there.
Got a quick little snack, a little yogurt, and some extra power. It should not be eaten on the live stream. I'm so sorry about that.
This is so hot.
Work up an appetite when I'm drawing. Alright. So, let's add a little bit of Lassard, and we'll come back, and from there we'll create some more of our flow, and that'll probably be it for this session. Not for the drawing. The painting will be to be continued on another day. We need some highlights here. There we go. Maybe a couple here. All right, Mr. Lassard. Let's. Remember, I'm looking at you, but I'm also looking at my screen behind you. There it is. Alright. So he has that blue, you know, we'll go blue and we'll go some charcoal, we'll go some gray as well too. I think that'll be okay. So we're gonna go that right over here. Because his base goes here and his base goes here. Now we got some everyday starting.
Let's have that shirt blend with that motion there.
You know what, we'll make him pop a little more. We'll put this nice good pink one right here for his highlights.
Yeah. Lift me up low. Lift me up low. You would be happy if you were mine too.
If this wasn't right here, I'd be doing a lot of motions. I'm going to have to get an arm eventually. And another thing to work toward. Leave a tip. Help me get that little clamp thing, clamp arm, and to put my phone here. Hook it up with the back of my easel.
Yes. Every day. Every day.
So I think what I want to do is use some of, it's gonna be different values of these shadows from here, his chin, neck area, from like going back down there, and then the flow of this, and then these will be slightly different, but they're almost gonna be the same value.
To right. You want to
kind of felt something there. It kind of feels like those are
what you got. Lay it down on me. Lay it down on me. Man, my butt is hurting. This chair sucks for long distance, so sorry. Yeah, I gotta get my pillow.
Woo. we go. Cool. Ooh, much better.
All right, let's bring it back. Let's bring it back.
See, now that all the other guys are starting to pop out, we'll eventually get to Roy popping out as well, too. His highlights won't really be much other than on his nose, upper eyebrows, and on top of that head to increase it and bring out that edge. But that will help define all this fuzziness right now. But Boyd is holding us with a nice good vertical direction. I know I shouldn't be doing this. Sorry about that. I just want... You know, it's only me doing the stream, and I'm limited with my phone and my webcam here. I kind of like to change it up and everything, and... Because it gets boring after looking at the same scene for so long, especially with drawing, and it's just my voice. So... I do it for you. Yep, love. Lift me up, love. Make me up love every day. And now, his piece is becoming a little bit more, now that we put his hair back in. Every day, honey. You see the difference of like how light that was compared to just that pressure there?
Dance with me.
So he has a slight, just a tiny, tiny turn this way, allowing me to get that and not getting that there, but that helps. But I need to see how the back of his hair is. There it is. And it kind of goes with that. Eventually just piece that together and carve it the way we need to carve it out. And by carving out, again, I just mean using the background colors as like an eraser in a sense of what doesn't work on the hair line. Different value of blue there. So I think what we need to do, since that kind of goes up like this a little bit, bum, bum.
There we go.
Such a beautiful sound, man.
There we go. Now we can fix that. Changes often. The week and the week begin. She is each other. Between us grow deeper. Let's just get a hint of shadow right underneath that nose nostril right there. Just a hint. That was popping out a little bit.
Get it, get it, get it, get it, get it.
Playing under the table and dreaming. Hey. Get it, get it, get it, get it, get it. People and every direction. The world's exchange, no time to exchange, no and all.
I think I messed up the lyrics right there. Sorry. I think I messed up a lot of the lyrics today.
Far away, then they all do it the same. They all do it the same. Bump, bump, bump. Bum 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 ba dum ba dum bum ba dum ba dum ba.
Bam! Let's cover that little piece off because I really want that there. Excuse me, folks. I knew it was coming, but it took like an hour to get there.
Let's get those shadows now on that.
right there.
Right there. There's a little hint right there.
Get it. You know, I don't think I want that there anymore. That lasted about 3 seconds.
There we go.
And let's go ahead and put this green in there. Introduce that one. And then back to the shadow.
Right.
And now
there we go.
Just little chunks at a time. It's down you up and I. All right, hour and 55 minutes. Folks, I think we're at a good place to stop for now. And as I say that, I'm like, nope.
You'll find that I do that probably every show.
Because, like, as soon as I tell myself that, it's like my eyes wake up a little bit more. I'm like, wait a minute, what about this? And then that needs to still get blended a little bit better.
That flat ground is, looks like it's part of the hair. There we go. And then, just follow me. To the end of this tunnel, you can go back in time on this time.
Alrighty, cool. Folks, I feel good about this stopping point here. Let me know what you think so far. And I'm going to pick it up another day. I'm not sure if I'll go live stream again, but follow my channel. Follow or subscribe to my channel. Keep track of my website. And let's go from there. Let's get a little more of a look. Alrighty. Cool. Alrighty. We're going to get there, folks. That's a little bit at a time. All right. Everyone, thanks again for watching. For those who are going to watch. And, yeah, have yourself a good night. And let me know what you think again in the comments. That is it. My name is Alex. And everyone, have yourself a good evening.